Omaha's police chief is on the record to justify an officer-involved shooting that killed a man New Year's Day. Now, we're asking why that man was even back on the streets. That's because Tyree Bell was a repeat offender. Good evening, I'm Rob McCartney.
I'm Brandi Peterson. Four officers opened fire Tuesday morning near 42nd and Pratt. In the end, the 31-year-old died from multiple gunshot wounds. Now, those four Omaha police officers are on paid administrative leave, which is standard procedure. Right now, Bell's background and why he's among a number of felons who often get the minimum prison sentence for carrying a gun. KETV News Watch 7's Ryan Luby is live.
Yes, Brandi, the Omaha Police Officers Association has been speaking out about this issue for weeks, if not months now. If you're a felon and you get caught carrying a gun, you go to jail. As we found out, Tyree Bell was among many convicted of that crime who oftentimes get the bare minimum sentence.
Police routinely respond to threats, and early Tuesday morning they found one, a man with a gun near 42nd and Pratt.
Who was armed with a pistol grip shotgun.
In this case, it was 31-year-old Tyree Bell, a man who not only threatened officers and himself with his words, but also with his body language.
On multiple occasions, while holding his son in front of him, he leveled the shotgun directly at the officers.
That's why officers ultimately shot him, killing him. Now, this wasn't the first time Bell's dealt with law enforcement. His rap sheet is 3 pages long. It includes crimes of assault, terroristic threats, and recently for illegally carrying a weapon as a felon. On that crime, he served the minimum sentence just 1 year under the old law that changed in 2010.
Especially somebody with a long record and a history of violence on their record, and they're given a slap on the wrist, that just compounds the problem.
Sergeant John Wells is president of Omaha's Police Officers Association. He's thrilled the legislature upped the minimum sentence for felons in possession of firearms to 3 years. But he says even that's not good enough in some cases. He points to each of these criminals who were also sentenced to a bare minimum sentence for the same type of crime. Chief Todd Schmatter said Wednesday that criminals used guns to commit 75% of all felonious assaults in Omaha last year. He looks at the minimum prison sentence issue like this.
Just given the totality and the macro numbers that I just said for the community of Omaha, I would like to see more than the minimum sentence given.
And a quick correction here. You saw those 7 mugshots a second ago. 6 out of the 7 actually were convicted of or sentenced to the bare minimum. 1 actually got a little bit more time than that. Now, so you know, I contacted Judge Atepka's office today. He is the presiding judge in district court here in Douglas County. At this point, he has not offered a comment. Reporting live, I'm Ryan Luby, KETV News Watson.